morning, everyone. Today is the 26th of February, and for once, our Sankofa flight will not land on a country, but on a treaty. This treaty is the final act of the Berlin Conference, which regulated European colonization and trade in Africa during the new imperialism period. Signed on this day in 1885, it divided Africa like an apple pie without the participation of Africans. Here are the details of a conference that changed forever the fate of the continent.
African History Daily by my daddy.
This conference was initiated by Otto von Bismarck, Chancellor of Prussia, on November the 15th in 1884. The goal was to divide Africa among colonial powers after all the various conflicts between them for control, also known as the Scramble for Africa. The Congo Basin, as vast as India, was yet still not owned by any European powers at the time, and therefore constituted a major interest for many reasons. First of all, King Leopold II, King of Belgium, had been dreaming of colonizing it and acquiring it as his own property. The French, already present in the region since September 1880, had a treaty with one of the local leaders through their lead explorer Savoyan de Brazza. The British and Portuguese were fighting over Portugal's presence in Mozambique and Angola, which prevented Britain from realizing the goal of colonizing from the Cape to Cairo. To make things worse, Germany started to gain interest in Black Africa for prestige and leverage. On February the 24th, 1884, the Reich decided to place all territories with German presence under his protection. Eventually, London acknowledged the sovereignty of Portugal over the area around the Congo River, leading to discontent from English traders and protest from Belgian king. The result became a need for international discussion on reaching an agreement on how to divide Africa. 14 European countries, the Ottoman Empire and the USA were present in discussion. Here are the biggest winners of the allocation contest. The great winner was King Leopold II, who, for his own personal use, acquired a vast territory in the middle of Black Africa, now known as the Independent State of Congo. The King of Belgium claimed to pursue a triple crusade in Africa, scientifically, diplomatically, and humanitarian, but he negotiated upstream with the Americans and with Bismarck to gain control of the coveted territories. Great Britain relinquished its ambition for the Congo Basin, but reinforced his hegemony from Cape to Cairo. The French received territories in sub-Saharan Africa, and Germany gained control of the majority of Southwest Africa. By the final act of the conference, signed, I quote, "in the name of Almighty God," by all the participants, Africa, this territory seen as a no man's land, has from now on not one, but several masters, all eager for gold, raw materials, and free labor. My African cliché of the day is about domination. Formerly dominated by masters with brutal war methods, Africa is today still dominated by several masters. Some of them are old ones, and some new ones already voracious, with more subtle but equally devastating methods stemming from savage capitalism, which breaks down the local enterprises and kills jobs. Whose fault do you think it is? The rulers or the dominated? It's up to you to think about it, to your own cliches, to our African continent, and I hope to see you tomorrow on the next flight of our Sankofa bird. Thank you.
If you like this podcast, don't forget to subscribe and post a comment on Apple Store or your usual podcast platform. This podcast is also available on Facebook and on our website, www.myafricancliche.com.